So now we discussed some questions related to some topics, but now I will tell you what exactly the topics to be covered. So for example, already we discussed what are the high weightage topics and what are the moderate weightage topics. So in high weightage topics, I told you instruction pipelining, cache memory mapping techniques, memory hierarchy, machine instructions and addressing modes. In the instruction pipelining, you concentrate on the hazards. That is the data hazards, control hazards, and then memory hazards, and also finding the number of clock cycles required to execute so and so instructions, and instruction type will be given and a description also will be given. You need to find out the total cycles required. Similarly, questions related to finding the throughput of pipelining system. So there will be comparison of multiple pipelining architectures, like for example, 5-stage pipeline compared with 6-stage pipeline. So what is the performance achieved by 6-stage pipeline? That means speed up of 6-stage pipeline when compared to 5-stage pipeline. That is nothing but naive pipelining and then efficient pipelining comparisons, or else comparison of non-pipelining and pipelining. Questions related to throughput of pipelining, questions related to comparison of this non-pipelining and pipelining to find out the speed up ratio. So time taken for non-pipelining divided by time taken for pipelining, you will get the speed up. Similarly, questions related to handling of hazards. Hazard is nothing but one instruction may get struck because of the data required from the previous instruction, or else one instruction may get struck to know the address of the next instruction because instruction is a branch instruction. So till the branch address is known, we have to wait. So that type of questions you concentrate more. And throughput, for 1 second, how many instructions we are able to execute? These type of questions are coming from instruction pipelining. In cache memory mapping techniques, so you need to find out the tag bits and also extra memory required for storing the tag information. So like in direct mapping, in the set associate mapping, in the fully associate mapping, how much extra memory required. Similarly, different types of cache misses, like cache compulsory miss, that is called cold start miss, or capacity miss, and also the miss related to conflicts in the direct mapping and set associate mapping, conflict misses. So how to find out the number of conflict misses, how to find out the number of capacity misses, etc. And in memory hierarchy, so different levels of memories will be given, like level 1 memory, level 2 memory, and also main memory, and also disk. So in this levels of hierarchy, if TLB is there or TLB not there, whatever it is, idea, but effective memory access time you have to find out. Related to the fetching of instructions, you may get the different access time. Fetching of data, you may get the different access time because data is stored in the data cache and instructions are stored in the instruction cache. So most related to the hierarchy of memory in different levels, how effectively we have to find out the access time of memory system. Because as and when the data is available in the low level memories, so it will be very easy to access, time will be lesser. When you go to the next levels, it takes more time. So based on the hit ratio, you have to improve the hit ratio. So the questions related to hit ratio and effective memory access time, or else sometimes effective memory access time will be given, hit ratio we need to find out for the given requirements, and machine instructions and addressing modes. So in this already we discussed some questions related to format of instructions. So okay, if three address instructions are these many, two address instructions are these many, how many one address instruction can be formulated? Similarly, if this is the instruction format and these are the opcode and then number of registers available, how to find out the number of bits reserved for the immediate operand? Okay, so in this format, you need to know how many bits are allotted to each entry. For example, in instruction format, opcode is there, register code part is there, memory part is there. So 64 registers, 6 bits we use. Maybe 1 megabyte of memory, 20 bits we use. If it is a total 32 bits, then you sum of all this, you have to subtract from the 32, then you will get the opcode bits. So that type of questions are coming on the machine instructions and addressing modes. Next, coming to the control unit design, you need to know the basics related to micro-programmed control unit and then hardwired control unit, and the RISC architecture and also CISC architecture. Then ALU and data path, how to design ALU, what are the instructions that are included in the design of ALU. And what are the data paths? Data paths means how to provide a medium in order to transfer of data from register to register or from register to memory or from memory to registers. Then interrupts and DMA. Interrupts how to handle interrupts, what are the different categories of interrupts. You need to know all the theory aspects related to the interrupts. How DMA is effectively executing when compared to the interrupt. Comparison of DMA and interrupt initiated IO. Something like if DMA takes certain time and interrupt program takes certain time, in this particular scenario, how much speed up a DMA can be achieved using the interrupt initiated IO. So usually when you compare the interrupts and DMA, DMA takes less time when compared to the interrupts. And secondary storage. Secondary storage means how the disk is organized, what are the different ways of organizing the disk, okay, and how to address the disk, and also finding the access time of disk, what is the rotational latency, what is the seek time, okay, how much time to it will take for an access of a file, and this much amount of file to access, how much time it takes, okay, rotational latency, how to find out, seek time. These are all questions related to secondary storage, related to the disk structure. So cylinders, tracks, sectors, etc. Maybe finding the capacity of the disk space based on the given data, like number of platers available, on each plater how many tracks are there, on each track how many sectors are there, what is the size of each sector. Based on that, we can find out the disk capacity, and also disk access time based on the seek time, and rotational latency based on the number of rotations it is making per minute. So this type of questions were asked in these topics.